So yesterday we were pushing a little bit. We practiced rainbow body yoga with some added dynamic concentration, and there was also Dorje Jolo empowerment in the evening. So there was quite a bit of hammering yesterday. Today we will chill. Just enjoy clear calmness, settledness, that basic sanity, basic groundedness, basic sobriety, basic kindness. You can give some attention to your posture so that it is upright but also comfortable at the same time. Your eyes can be open or closed, however you prefer, or you can use both, alternating every few minutes. However you feel like alternating the gaze. Eyes can be aimed slightly downwards, straight ahead horizontally, or slightly upwards. You can also try, if you like, and if you wish to make a little change, you can also gaze a little bit to the left or a little bit to the right. And of course, you can change gazes. What I mean by left and right, I will demonstrate to you. So now I'm looking straight ahead. My eyes are like this. And when I look right, it's just this much. So from the center to the side. Center to the left. Center to the left, just a little bit. Basic clarity, basic space that is full of fantastic pure energy, full of energy, full of light, pure energy. This we recognize. We recognize ourselves as selfless, yet knowing. It's not selfless and unconscious. Selfless, knowing, heart full of kindness, butt and feet grounded, whole being grounded. Ourselves as so-called Buddhas, awake beings. When you have recognition and stay in the recognition of ourselves as Buddhas, we are literally Buddhas. We are no different from the historical Buddhas, Mahasiddhas of the past, Mahasiddhas of the present or future. Exactly the same. Since we have Buddha nature, we can also realize, actualize, and embody it. if we didn't have the knowing cognizant ability, then we wouldn't have Buddha nature. And we couldn't realize it either. But then we wouldn't be suffering either. In that case, our psyche would be much more simple or primitive. So in Buddhist art and iconography, we have all these paintings, like on many of your walls behind you, there are images of Buddhas and gurus, deities. When we have recognition, whether it is 1 second or 10 minutes or all the time, then we are those Buddhas in the center of the so-called mandala. Mandala means field of influence. It's like a vibrational field. This vibrational field is all life. All life is the mandala. So when our own Buddha nature is recognized, no matter if it is a second or 5 minutes or more or without time limitation, then we are the so-called Buddha in the center of the so-called mandala. We are simply awakened beings. Beings that are not for a moment swayed by thoughts, emotions, reactions, negative habits, negative reactions. That is not clouded by gray energies of dullness, drowsiness, depression. Simply clear, awake. And when we can have a recognition that lasts a second or 2 seconds, it means that it can be repeated. If you feel like you have, I've been talking about the two modes, and the first thing is always to establish the basic state. No matter what, always establish when it is not recognized, when we are not in the recognition of it. So if necessary, you can shout hungpets if you are not sure or if you know that you don't have it. Cut through the stuff of the mind, make a hole, and this basic state automatically shows up when you make a hole. So that is always number one, get back into recognition. I've also been talking about the second mode, the mode of Vipassana. And in this case, when you cut through the mind, make a hole, and recognition returns, then you look back into your mind, samsaric mind, mind of movement, mind of excitement, mind of confusion. To release the self-based confusion. Let breathing flow normally, without tensions. Let the body sit very relaxed, upright, but soft like the body of a baby. Thank you. if you start getting sleepy, and if it doesn't affect your clarity, go ahead, fall asleep, let it happen. If it does affect your clarity, then try becoming more aware. If you can, might be difficult because it already affects the system. But don't sit ice fishing. Don't sit nodding. So then it's good if you are affected by sleepiness, wake yourself up. You can stand up, run around the house 10 times, and then come back. Drink a pot of coffee as you're running. What I mean by that is that, you can shake your body, you can stand up, you can do vajra bodies, vajra breaths, splash water on your face and cold, cool water on your ears, on your neck, on your throat, and wake yourself up in any of these ways. But don't sit nodding on retreats. At some point in practice, when you have enough experiential confidence about the basic state, it gets easier. First it gets easier, and then it keeps getting easier to fall asleep without losing it, especially in the sitting posture where the spine is upright. I believe this is the reason why actually widely in Mahayana Buddhism, which is sutric, they practice sitting up during the night. This can have also negative, especially health consequences, but nevertheless they do that because they want to use the night time for practice as well. Anyway, when you gain some confidence, it gets easy to slip into the sleep without losing basic recognition. So you fall asleep sitting up. We all have fell asleep sitting up in trains and airplanes, buses, car trips. No different, except here the context is practice. Take a few deep breaths. And then you can open your eyes. If you feel like moving a bit, stretching a bit, okay, it's we've been at it for an hour. Let's take a break of 15 minutes. And then after that, I'm sure we all would love to hear a discussion about emptiness from Lama Karl and Acharya Ugi together. So you guys can start in 15 minutes.